javelins, freelancers, ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to a special report from Anthem Universe. I am but one of your hosts here, Ogaz, and today we're going to take a look at something fresh, something different in Anthem game music. Now, there's a reason we're doing this video, and that's because Sarah Schachner has just been confirmed the composer for Anthem moving forward, which is super exciting. The BioWare team have released Valor, the Freelancer theme, which is available from the BioWare blog and, of course, on their Twitter. If you haven't seen it, do check it out. But critically, I thought it was important that we came back to this. Anthem Universe spent some time analyzing the original noises and sounds coming out of the Twitch feed and wherever we could get it. Now, this is the official feed, and it's something more exciting for us. So we're going to take a look at that now. We're going to assess, critique, and discuss the current theme and perhaps any adjustments that perhaps have come along the journey. So sit back and enjoy as we assess and review the Valor Freelancer theme. Game and film musical scores carry a weight, a persona, a responsibility. They shape our experiences and they reinforce a tale's impact. They drive emotions, raise doubts, create suspense, and document our journey. They are checkpoints, tragedies, triumphs, memories, beginnings, and ends. And critically, they are part of the factors that contribute to the video games as art argument. Anthem, so far at least, appears to benefit from this philosophy. We can already hear a handful of interesting effects, leitmotifs, and themes that appear throughout the recording. So firstly, what is a leitmotif, I hear you ask? Well, these are audio themes or cues that recur. They create a sense of attachment to a character, an environment, or a thing. And I refer to thing for a reason that we'll explore shortly. Indeed, there are at least 3 to 4 recurring Anthem leitmotifs that we could probably identify today. Now, the main theme starts with a beautiful yet ghostly 15-second choral melisma in the vein of X-Files or Twilight Zone. It recurs again later, but it evokes this old-world eerie sensation with a sudden shift between notes over one syllable. Is this alien melisma meant to represent the anthem of creation? Is it a call from the relics? Is it the gods themselves, the shapers? Now, many have compared the theory of the anthem of creation to that of the Force in Star Wars, you know, an energy that's represented audibly by Williams's masterful and iconic track, Binary Sunset. Now, unlike Binary Sunset in Star Wars, this sensation is much less fanfare. It's far more electronic and alien in nature. Whatever the sound is, it commences our journey with Anthem in a slightly disconcerting way. Cue French horns, trombones, brass, and strings, oh the strings. What better way to distract an audience than by juxtaposing an eerie opening to a medieval-esque fanfare? Now, the fanfare's classic, yet compulsory. It's our new leitmotif that we see. It hypes the gamer and sets the tone for the journey to come. It's the Star Wars medal ceremony, Game of Thrones, and Superman all in one. And pop culture laps it up. From here, the track calls on some softened concert tom-toms, a bass drum, to drone a militaristic beat and carve the way for a new theme. So here, this crescendo of the previous fanfare ends, and the heartbeat of the track begins. Now, curiously here, there's an electronic syncopated bass line, and it starts to fade, and it joins the backbone of the track. It's subtle, but it's a little angry, almost Mass Effect-like in tone. The strings quickly join, though. They provide this new, yet familiar tune. You can hum it, easily. You know, it's that same soft strings melody that ensured you would never skip the opening to a Game of Thrones episode. It's also addictive. You're humming it now, aren't you? Da-da-da. The theme loops a second time by marrying trombones, tubas, and harmonizing trumpets to mimic the melody and add punch to the soft lulls of the strings' now familiar tune. The royalty has arrived. You can almost hear it, the pomp and ceremony, the grandness of Fort Tarsus, the mighty javelins of old, the decoration of Queen Tarsus herself, the fanfare of the golden days. It's grand and epic, but it's still dark and foreboding. There's just something not quite right here. This curiosity draws us into the bridge of the theme. With a heavy emphasis on strings and the odd trombone, it quickly whirls up and down, major and minor. It's almost luring the listener to a hopeful position. The light, the truth, but then it snatches that assurance away as quickly as it began. It builds to the second crescendo. And we're hit with a volley of trumpets and oscillating strings, overcoming the darkness, winning struggle, ready to step into the light, ready to hear that grand, awesome theme return. But it doesn't. Instead, we get something much, much different. This quasi-tribal rhythm develops. A filtered didgeridoo effect surges and gradually builds an ancient tune alongside thumping mallets as they grind against a tribal drum. We could be wrong here, but it gives off a real ska vibe for us. You know, this complete shift in tone, it represents something different in the Anthem universe. It reminds us of the ska hideout that we first saw in June 2018. The spines on the backs of its inhabitants, the dark nest-like huts scattered across the land. Next to that, this deep alien synthesized voice rumbles to support the didgeridoo sounds. Together they build, unknowing where it's going to take us. But the uncertainty dissipates quickly. With little notice then, the full ensemble returns, the javelins fly, and we hear that ancient droning didgeridoo seamlessly crossfade into a modern synthesized bass. It defines the return of the fanfare, but it reminds us that underneath the familiar and bright strings of the anthemic anthem lies the foundations of an ancient and darker place. It's a fitting metaphor for the world at large. And then you start humming again. The alien choral melisma makes a comeback. It plays as a counterpoint to the warming melody that's now whirling from the full ensemble. The javelins are in cruise mode, the sky blurs. Now, at this point, you're humming again. The strings enchant you with their own melisma, moving up and down the scale, as if charming a snake or a javelin to confront and subdue the alien tones. We are left then with empty nothingness. With the fanfare gone, the alien choral sound echoes through the land. The anthem of creation signifies its intent. More than an energy field, it battles against the call of the relics whilst they're active, pulsing, surging, waiting for the relics to be silenced. But the javelins are gone. They've triumphed as one. Or have they? What remains out there? It doesn't matter. A lone, disconcerting violin grinds an off-key whine. It's unnerving, it's destabilizing. The final synthesized bass is then heard, quickly overpowered by the sounds of the ancient. Fade to silence. Now, from what we've seen with these changes, with the adjustments made, and the new recording from Sarah Schachner and team, we are very excited to know what's coming before us. This sound is more bombastic, the drum effects have greater reverb, the strings are more punchy, the trumpets and the brass are more bombastic, everything feels cleaner, crisper. The recording is far better in quality than what we heard before, and it's only a subtle difference that maybe some of you haven't picked up, but it is something special, and I think it's something worth your while. So go back, take a listen after today, and enjoy. Game musical scores carry a weight. As I said, they're a persona, a responsibility. They shape your experiences and they reinforce a tale's impact. They are checkpoints, tragedies, triumphs, memories, beginnings, and ends. So far, Anthem, with its leitmotifs and themes, encourages us to think about the journey ahead. It also leverages acoustics as a real purpose to the game, with reference to Anthem, the anthem of creation, and the very design of the relics themselves. Its sound is confident yet eerie, and it remains formulaic enough to be familiar, even welcoming. But in the weeks and months ahead, we look forward to not just seeing, but hearing the music and sounds of Anthem. It's clear that strong audio design will be advantageous to the outcome of this game. For music can name the unnameable and communicate the unknowable. I'm Ogaz, this is Anthem Universe, and you can check us out at Anthem Universe on Twitter. Join the Discord, join the community, and engage in some of this love, which is discord.anthemuniverse.com. Of course, check us out on YouTube, and last but certainly not least, the podcast Anthemcast, of course, continues to enjoy its popularity. Please join that at anthemuniverse.com/anthemcast. Thank you for listening, and we'll see you next. Over the wall.